Morning, my East Paulding Raiders. I hope you guys had a great month of March and a great morning today. My name is Alan McMorris, and I will also be your host for this month's episode of EPTV. Thank you guys so much for tuning in today, as we have a lot more exciting things for you today, including the announcements and the segments, so you won't want to miss any of this. But before we talk about the announcements or the segments, I want to give a huge and special shout out and happy birthday to our producer here, Alicia Rivera. She has just turned 17. So I need you guys to do something for me. When you see her in the hallway, give her a big happy birthday and shower her with as much love as possible. She has finally turned 17. Happy birthday, Alicia. Let's all give her a round of applause. Okay, now heading into the announcements. For the announcements, we made a few minor tweaks to it by adding some new information, but nonetheless, we still got them here for you today, so let's head straight into it. For the forecast, for the month of April, you might want to stay as hydrated as possible, as the high temperature for the month of April will be a 73 degrees and the low temperature will be a 46 degrees. It's going to be pretty hot, so make sure whenever you leave the house, you know, you take a water bottle with you. After that, we have the question of the month. The question of the month is, who is the first woman ever to attend college? You guys know? I don't think you guys know that. That's a little bit of, you know, historical question. But if you don't, we have the answer at the end of the announcements for you. Next, we have the woman spotlight of the month. And the woman that we would love to spotlight this month is Natalia Tarp. She is in JROTC. And a little fun fact, she is one of the hosts of the new Three Petals in the Garden podcast alongside Noma Alayi and one of our producers, Alicia Rivera. Later on, you guys will get to see a glimpse into her life. And lastly, we have the quote of the month. And the quote of the month is, if your dreams do not scare you, then they are not big enough. And that quote is by Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. And there you guys have it. That's all we have for the announcements today, guys. We hope you guys enjoyed watching the announcements for this month's episode of EPTV. And now, to the segments.
Guys,
what time you got here?
Anyways, we're doing a Freeform project, right? I think we should definitely do.
We're not making it TikTok.
Well, maybe we should do something like educational, like something that our peers can relate to. According to the World Health Organization, your adolescence roughly lasts 10 years, from ages 10 to 19. Day after day, waking up at the same time to go to the same classes, eat the same lunch, and go home just to repeat the same process over and over. It isn't easy handling both school and everything else life might throw at you. For some people, it's harder than others. It isn't easy to look at your reflection to see the same blank stare and fake smile you've always seen. Changing your clothes is the most difficult task to overcome. Depression, anxiety, and behavioral disorders are among the leading causes of illness and disability among adolescents. Just because it's unnoticed doesn't make it any less present. Before you know it, your time is up. Suicide is the fourth leading cause of death among 15 to 19 year olds. One more empty desk, an unoccupied bedroom, and one less person who can make a change. Although it doesn't always result to this, the World Health Organization has stated that the consequences of failing to address adolescent mental health conditions extend to adulthood, impairing both physical and mental health and limiting opportunities to lead fulfilling lives as adults. You and me can only handle so much. Check on your friends and take care of yourself.
That's a good idea. What other stuff y'all want to film?
I feel like we should do a video introducing the school to someone who's never been here before.
Yeah, how could we film that though?
I was thinking something like...
Thank you.
That's cute, I like it. But I still think we should do a video on the importance of music, though. I'm all for it.
That's so cute. How would we do that?
Well, first.
Nah, mine's better.
Oh really? What's your video?
It's basically just a vlog about me.
Okay, I just woke up. It's about 7:23. Get dressed, get ready to go to school.
What up, Anthony?
What?
Yes, I do.
How'd you make it all about yourself?
Exactly. Yeah.
Oh, I guess we'll just take a zero.
You mean like when? You mean like?
Yeah, I guess we'll just fail.
Yep, we got tomorrow.
School.
How do we even film that?
Well, I was thinking something like...
Putting on a show isn't as easy as it seems. There is so much that goes on behind the scenes to put on an iconic EPHS performance. Hours of choreography, set building, blocking, lighting, design, and trial and error goes into making a show.
Behind the scenes, there's a lot of hard work going into it. A lot of people don't realize how hard these actors work to get the final product of the show. We spend days perfecting our choreography, perfecting like our blocking, everything. There's so much work that goes into it.
Putting on a performance can be a lot of work. It can be a lot of stress. You're building backstage. There's a lot that goes on behind a show that people don't see.
Despite the hard work and stress these actors endure, they wouldn't change it for the world.
Yes, we're working, but everything we do is together. It's with another castmate. We're always together, you know, talking to each other, you know, making friendships. It's amazing, and I'll always remember that. I've made so many memories already in theater.
It gets you out of your comfort zone a lot, like if you're shy. And just being on stage, like, that's a different experience for you. Instead of just, like, hiding in the back,
it allows people to express themselves in ways that they can't maybe verbally say or physically say, because they can go on stage and they can express themselves through a different character.
It's really exciting because just you get to perform what you've been doing for months in front of an audience, and they get to enjoy it with you, and it's just a lot of fun.
It's brought me so many friends that have become family, and it's helped me through my high school career, and it's just brought a lot of joy into my life.
Because I just love it, like everything about it.
It is clear that the show has left a lasting impact on these actors' lives that they will remember for years to come.
East Paulding High School offers many different types of clubs, but not many people know about the Chick-fil-A Leadership Academy. Today, I will be educating you and maybe opening an interest to join this club.
I think it's a really great program we have going on here. It's been a lot of fun. I've been able to do it the last 4 years due to COVID. But it's great. It's teaching me how to go out in my community and really make an impact just through simple actions. Honestly, I was sitting in the lunchroom with my best friend Rena, and we saw one of the posters, and she was like, yo, they got a Chick-fil-A like club here, we should do it. And I was like, okay. And then I joined up, and then once I got to really learn more about it, it's really amazing. It teaches students to go out again in their community and really make an impact. I really learned how to be a leader, and really just also like plan events. So something we're doing right now for our Do Good December, well, as well as just our end of the year action plan, is the Cinderella Ball. So a couple of us are getting together and planning events, and that's something really important, especially going in the marketing field in the future. I need to know how to plan events, and this is allowing me to do so. Oh my goodness, we've done many. One of my favorite things I look forward to, we weren't able to do it this year, but it's our Do Good December project, and we go to the Boys and Girls Club and we just hang out with them. We do activities, we provide them gifts, we do donations, and just gather toys so that way we're giving back to those kids that might not get a Christmas. So that's one of my favorite things because I actually get to go and meet them and hang out with them and just have a little blast. It's a giving back to the community and just teaching about leadership and responsibility and roles and really how to make an impact on your community. I say a go-getter because nothing can be done unless you actually go and work towards the actions. I mean, you can do the talk, you can walk the talk, but you can't always do the actions. So I think it's very important that you have someone that wants to do good and wants to implement and work hard to be the best leader they can be. Absolutely. It's been an absolute blast the last 4 years, and I'm so sad to not do it next year, but I highly recommend doing it because I've been able to meet so many new people in the school that maybe I wouldn't have been able to without this club. And also it just teaches me to go out again in my community and really figure out like the importance of community service and the importance of giving back.
The Leadership Chick-fil-A Academy is a leadership program for students that is led by students that will impact the community. The Chick-fil-A Leadership Academy is a good fit for students that want to, one, impact the community, want to give back. Another is if they're a type of student, they want to be good helpers. The Chick-fil-A Labs and the Leadership Academy helps build students to become better leaders for the future. Chick-fil-A has itself. Chick-fil-A has done many, many things. It's been there since, I think their first one was called the Chick-fil-A Dwarf. And Truett Cathy, which is the owner and the leader, he believed in students. He believed in nourishing the potential in every child. And as I believe in building and nourishing students to become leaders for the future, it's just a great thing to be a part of that. And they've been doing it for years. They have a track record that's awesome. The leadership skills that the students learn are very beneficial, not only here in the school, but also out as they grow up to be leaders themselves. Wow, they have done so many things. They have done read-alongs, which they videotaped, and they read various books to students in the elementary. They have worked with the Boys and Girls Clubs by doing Christmas crafts. They have been a part of the nursing homes, making greeting cards and doing all sorts of things to give back to the community. They have made little packets for health packets with toothpaste and toothbrushes and things of that nature. So they really hone in on times when you're doing the holidays, and then also just the impact that they have had in the community with other entities. Again, as I said, nursing homes, elementary schools, things like that. Again, Truett Cathy believed life is always about people. Who are the people? Students are our future, and they are the people. So the academy was built so that they could provide them resources to teach them how to be leaders so that it will become a domino effect, so they can affect change for the better.
Now that you know about the Chick-fil-A Leadership Academy, hopefully you'll consider becoming a wonderful leader in helping our community and helping us high schoolers make a difference. If you're considering this club, contact Mrs. Hayes and Coach Davis for more information. Thank you.
Mr. Aiden Lerner is a KSU graduate who majored in education with a passion for music, although this wasn't his first choice.
My childhood. So I lived in New Jersey for 4 years, and then I moved down to about 30 minutes south of Atlanta, Georgia, which is where I spent my entire life until I went to college. Raised by my mom and dad, we've had pets my whole life. It's been a great time. So I studied piano for 10 years when I was a kid, and then when I joined band, I became a clarinet. I became a trumpet player, actually. Became a trumpet player in fifth and sixth grade, and then I picked up clarinet after that, up until I graduated. So I was part of Drum Corps International for 3 years. I was the drum major for Southwind Drum and Bugle Corps for the 2016 season, and then I did Spirit of Atlanta as the drum major in 2017 and 2018. Drum Corps, if you don't know, is basically professional marching band, except you pay to do it. You don't get paid like professional sport. You pay to audition, and you pay to be a part of it. I was drum major all those 3 years, and then I took my experience from being a professional drum major into teaching drum majors. I've been teaching drum majors since I was 18. Fresh out of high school, before I really even started college, I was teaching drum majors all over the state. I travel the state and travel really this whole Southeast, judging drum majors in marching band competitions and teaching drum majors all over the Southeast. It actually wasn't. So I was at Kennesaw State for 5 years, and my entire first year I spent as a software engineering major, and I very quickly realized that that was not right for me. So I was skipping software engineering classes to go and teach a local marching band, and that quickly made me realize that, hey, if I'm skipping my major classes, I should probably switch to education if that's what I'm liking doing. The person that inspired me to become a music educator was the person that taught me how to conduct and gave me like leadership lessons. His name's Matt McCord. He is currently a judge and attorney in Henry County, Georgia. Before that, he was a chorus teacher, and then quickly realized that that was not enough to support a family and became an attorney, and now he's a judge. Matt McCord, he is one of the local leadership and drum major guys along with myself. He is a fantastic human being, and I really, really strive to make my life look like he would want it to look, and how he models his life. I try to model mine like his. Seeing that aha moment go off in everybody's eyes, when they finally click, especially in a really hard, in a hard lesson that we've been going over, when it finally clicks for those kids, it blows your mind. My end goal for teaching in general is to make better musicians, but moreover, better human beings for the world. The world needs more band kids.
Atlanta is a city known for its skyscrapers and architecture. Mr. Wilson's class is bringing the intricate feel to the students of East Paulding High School.
It's impossible to live without architecture. Think about it. Where do you go every day? Home. How'd you get the house? Architecture. Do you go and sit out in the parking lot? No, you go to an architectural structure.
The students in the class are learning to use the industry standard software AutoCAD, creating blueprints and assigning of buildings from common suburban houses to super tall skyscrapers in Dubai. With the help of the class, students have been introduced to real architectural and engineering tasks and have even earned awards for their work, like Evan Weaver, who is the Architectural Student of the Year.
This class has really showed me how to work in an engineering field. So I think really I just did a lot of the work, and I did what he told me to do, and that got me to the level I needed to be to get the award.
Mr. Wilson's class is not only preparing students for architecture.
And this class also showed me the work ethic I'll need to get into engineering, and it inspired me through this the work we were doing.
The training that we do here just doesn't train people for architecture. We have students that leave here and go to work immediately in the field of surveying. We have students that leave here to go and major in aerospace engineering. We've got a student that took classes from me that has a glass blowing company. He's a student that bought his own truck at, 19 or 20? Just crazy stuff.
Mr. Wilson hopes to inspire other students with this class to pursue architecture and other related fields like engineering.
Thank you guys so much for watching EPTV. All of us professionals here at Redder Studios really appreciate it. Have a great day.